And now we'll call upon Dr. Chandramohan.
Respected chairpersons, the RIRS complications are less spoken except the sepsis and ureteric injuries. Whatever my experience I'm sharing here, there are various classifications like modified Sattva, ureteral injury RIRS by Oliver Traxler, sir, and regular classification Clavin. Intraoperative ureteroscopy complications using modified Sattva is like this: mild bleeding, minimal mucosal injury, inability to reach the stone itself is a complication. Then grade 2 is like if incident treated with endoscopic surgery. Grade 2A, mucosal injury, inability to reach the stone, ureteral perforation managed by stenting. When you see these complications, then incidence is very high. And Oliver Traxler classification is like this: simple, no lesion found, ureteral mucosal erosion, ureteral wall injury with adventitial perforation, and total avulsion. Total avulsion, we should not see. That's a very significant complication. Modified Clavin complication is like routine, but in this case, even colic due to blood clots, retention due to blood clots is a complication. We underestimate this, but patient has to stay 2-3 days extra time, and sometimes blood transfusion. Stent migration, strain strasse, stone migration, ureteral perforation, ureteral avulsion. They are very important. Urosepsis is stage 4B. Urosepsis is stage 4B. We all know how difficult. Sometimes bleeding can be managed with blood transfusion, but your antibiotics are limited. And this is what. Now, with this, I will share my videos. This is my first grade 1 injury when I was less than 50 cases. After that, I did not injure because I feel stent, if anything. This is my junior who has done the injury, grade 2, because of the forcible insertion, but I could get away with this. This is a grade 3, again my junior has done a little more severe injury, but was not requiring the ureteric reimplantation. And this is my, one stone is done like this, and in the re-look, he has taken lightly. He has inserted the axis sheath. After that, he did not bother. Patient developed a fever, sepsis. See this. This is a severe injury I have seen. If you see white plaque-like tissue, it's not good. Probably it may form stricture. So stent, but got away with that. Whenever ureter is tried, don't do this. This is one injury I wanted to tell. A big stone, see what's happened here. Again done sometime. See the laser fiber touching the here and there. Multiple times. See the guide wire. If you do 4-5 times, guide wire will break. So extra guide wire, you have to be careful when you're doing the lithotripsy. This is a stricture, like a urethral stricture. Take it for granted, if it is upper ureteric stricture, they end up with nephrectomy. Honestly, this is the worst complication I had. 5 years back, this stricture, patient did not follow. Silent hydronephrosis, one day came with pyonephrosis, less than 10% function. When I have done nephrectomy lap, it was very, very difficult. Very, very difficult. I feel upper ureteric damage is equal to nephrectomy. Equal to nephrectomy. So don't meddle with the access sheath in the upper ureter, or don't use the laser too inadvertently in the upper ureter. This is a laser touch, how it bleeds. Just when you pass the laser fiber, you don't realize, slowly it bleeds. If it happens in the infant develop, disaster. Now this is one case which is very threatening for me. I know why, what happened. It's a large stone. I was in a hurry to make the fragmentation. Suddenly some amount of the vision loss, and at the end, by the time I finished, but when I came out of the scope, literally frank bleeding, as if it is from the artery. So if you see what happens in infundibular region, if you are firing too fast, holmium laser especially, high energy, will perforate. No way you can stop it. And mind you, angioembolization may not be easy in these cases because it's not a major vessel at the infant, submucosal vessel bleeding. It is more difficult to manipulate. I will fast forward. This is a stone. I finished at the end when I was doing like this, some amount of blood. If you flush too much, still blood is coming. Either you stop it or think, what is it? See, like this. Suddenly if it comes, see, this is the infundibulum of the upper calyx. Is the same one which gets injured in PCNL. So when I came out of the access sheath, I was able to finish. This is the picture at the end. This is the picture. Then I would see the bleeding. See the bleeding. I had a camera in the theater. Immediately I could record this. I was, fraction of a second, I was thinking what to do if it doesn't off. Immediately I removed the access sheath. I waited with 3-way irrigation. then small flocules have come. By the time I am out, see, this is a bleeding. I was pressing, thin patient, I was pressing the kidney out of enthusiasm. But after 1 minute it stopped. If it doesn't stop in the theater, I have to do nephrectomy. In fact, I was ordering for, suddenly the color changed like this. Once these flocules have formed, I was confident that I am getting away. Then the moment I went inside, the clots were there. So holmium is sometimes, this is the calcium rupture scope. I was doing a live workshop while talking, I pushed the P7, which is very good scope, but it is thick. See, it suddenly went out. See. A stone is still there, nice stone. I haven't started. So beyond this over enthusiasm or while talking, laser fiber or this, if you push, see the RGP. The moment you see RGP like this, stop the procedure because it's extravasation. Entire surgery, maybe 100, 200 ml may go out. See, when I go up, this is the extravasation. Not good. So the rigid scope, it's like rigid scope perforating the calyx. This is one thing. This is next one is entrapment of basket. This is very good. Many times I might have shown, I could not assess the depth of the stone. The basket, two sides will come in one row, then it is difficult. I'm trying to pull, it is not coming out. You can't pull forcibly. Somebody was asking, what will you do? I have cut it and by the side of it I have gone. By the side of it, going and then doing is not easy. So I use laser, then slowly that frank, the four francs, they are breaking. See, it's broken like this. One is okay. If two, three are broken, removing that piece becomes difficult. So I was not comfortable to do such a big stone inside the basket. It's not easy also. You feel uncomfortable. Then I did PCNL and removed it. The story did not end there. Then I tried to remove the basket, it was not coming out. See, it's not coming out. It's holding something. I cut it and artery forceps I have applied. It's coming like kilometers. What's happening is it's uncoiling. What is the compressed loop is uncoiling. That looks, uncoiled loop looks totally, uncoiled loops looks like this, and this is the picture. This is a picture. So you should know your this thing. There was a coil, compressed coil is there. When you are pulling, you don't know whether it comes, it won't be seen on CM. So both ends, mandrel as well as the outer core, both I have compared, and then I came out. This is a broken scope. That is a very good scope. See, I was doing like this in the upper calyx. It is very, very good scope. I could do it 80% of it, and suddenly I noticed that in the CM, my laser fiber is not going. See, in this position I was doing fine, but suddenly I noticed that in the CM there is a breakage. Extreme torque on the external rotation I was doing. This is a post-pyloretotomy. See, after some time it is broken. So because it's a disposable scope, I could get away with this. Now you see, up to this point it was okay, and see now here it's broken. So when laser fiber is not, see, like it's broken. What happens is your laser fiber doesn't go, and it doesn't, you cannot reinsert anything, but still intactness is there. So these are the complications which you see. This is a recent, last 1 week back I was doing, just within 1 minute, these four dots have become 100 dots. This happens only when you don't have space and you forcibly try to do something. Suddenly these many dots have come. This is a problem. If it is in the center, it's just in pediatrics, in acute angle, without sheath, multiple times entry, this can happen. So infective complications, I am not going in detail, you all know that. Thank you very much for your valuable time.
Thank you, Dr. Chandramohan. I have one question. Tell me few points, how to prevent infections, pre-op, intra-op and post-op. Few tips.
One urine culture sterile. Two, even if it is positive, make sure it is sterile, which is difficult in private practice, or else give antibiotics minimum 2 days. Put a stent and do in those cases. Outflow you watch. I feel most important is outflow, whether it is from the bladder or from the access sheath. And don't spend too much time in such kidney. Don't take a big stone which is infected. Do proper PCNL, then better. So at least first 100 cases, do not take more than 1.5 centimeters. That may save. Thank you.